for those of you who don't know what ironic means, Simon, it's like these guys judging a talent competition.
Hey, buddy, what's your name?
My name is JJ.
JJ, how old are you?
I just turned 7.
Just turned 7?
Yeah.
What made you want to audition on Australia's Got Talent?
I just wanted to be able to make the whole, like, all of Australia laugh.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mate, we've got an audience here who can't wait to see what you've got in store for us.
Okay.
Stage is yours, my friend. Good luck.
Thank you. It was so cool being backstage on Australia's Got Talent, hanging out with all those people who are just desperate to get on TV. Hey, Ricky Lee.
Oh my God! Grand buzzers!
Lucy! I heard you were in Legally Blonde. So tell me, what do you call a really smart blonde?
What?
A golden retriever. Dead.
So cute.
Guess what?
What?
I got a girlfriend. But I think I'm going to have to dump her because there's someone new. Hey there, pussycat. Ever dated an Australian? Manu! My mum loves watching you on MasterChef. A bit of a style tip. You look so much better without the cravat. Should respect my elders. You've been a cooking judge for 10 years now, eating nothing but panna cotta, beef cheeks. So it got me thinking, what's your excuse, Shane?
What a legend!
JJ!
Hey!
Oh,
how you doing?
Yeah.
You are just the diddiest little thing. I want to eat you up. You're so cute.
Thank you.
I'm a little scared of you.
What can you say? As usual.
You are the funniest 7-year-old I've ever met.
Thank you.
And probably more talented than some of the stand-up comedy that we've seen so far.
For a 7-year-old, you have a massive personality and you absolutely take the stage like somebody a lot bigger than you.
Thank you. Thank you.
JJ, where you're standing right now was where my career started at the age of 10 on that stage. And this venue has been amazing to me. It started my whole career. This venue has the ability to launch careers. And do you know how they get launched?
No.
By one lucky break. And do you know how they can come?
How?
They can come in gold.
Jokes.
Hey, can you be nice to me next time?
Right, have a look at this fella. Hello there.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Fancy going on stage?
Yes.
Great. What's your name?
Ned.
Come on, Ned.
Come on, Ned, let's get you
let's
on.
Let's get going.
Onto the star and give it your best shot. Good luck, Ned.
Good luck, Ned.
Is that you, Deck? Please, sir, tell us your name.
I'm Ned.
How old are you, Ned?
I'm 8.
Cool. Where are you from?
Maidstone.
Oh. Who's here with you today?
Well, I'm with my mum, my dad, my stepmum, my sister, my other sister, and my brother.
Fantastic. Do you perform for friends and family? Do you get up in school and do shows?
Yeah. I think it was probably about 2 years ago that I started, and I practiced with my dad and mum with bananas and hairbrushes as microphones. My whole school knows that I'm at Britain's Got Talent today. And when I told my friends, they all went... If I got through, I'd be like, yes, forever. It's like smiley face times a million.
The stage is yours, sir. Good luck.
Oh, I love him already.
Come on, Ned.
Why were people so excited about that talking dog on Britain's Got Talent? Amanda Holden's been on it for years. I want to start a fight. Savage. It was really fun meeting Ant and Deck backstage, but I'm never quite sure which one's supposed to be the funny one.
Oh, he's killing us all!
Alicia?
Oh, no.
Yeah. Alicia laughing?
Oh, no.
At least you're not dancing.
That was good.
Simon.
Godson!
He reminds me a lot of my dad. He's a cross-dresser. He gets especially cross when he can't find his socks. I was really worried for David Williams when he swam in the River Thames for charity because of all that garbage going in his mouth. But since I've been watching BGT, I'm relieved it's all coming out again.
Ned, I loved the way that you took the mickey out of us. It was really quite savage.
I loved you the minute you walked out on stage. Hilarious. Well done.
I think the way you delivered those jokes, your timing was brilliant.
Ned, you look sort of nice and sweet,
But you're very cheeky, and that's why I like you, Ned. I'd like to kick this off with a big, fat yes.
It's a whoop from me.
Ned, I would love to hear you again. It's a yes from me.
Yes!
Come back and destroy us all for good next time. Well done. You got four yeses, Ned.
He's funny.
Now then, do I hook you up? What? I'm not quite sure. Yes, we do.
You look so sweet and innocent.
I know.
Did you enjoy it out there?
Yeah.
Did you?
Now, next up tonight is an amateur act who's still new to show business, still finding his way. But he's made a bit of a name for himself by teasing us and the judges.
Steve Mulhern?
No, not Stephen Mulhern, although if the cap fits. No, it's schoolboy comedian Ned Woodman.
I'm Ned Woodman, I'm 8, and I'm a comedian.
Why were people so excited about that talking dog on Britain's Got Talent? Amanda Holden's been on it for years.
I don't think Amanda liked my joke about her.
Savage.
But even though Amanda buzzed me, I think she still enjoyed the performance.
It's a whoop from me.
Well done, you got four yeses, Ned.
To get four yeses made me really happy. After my audition, I performed a gig at my school.
It was really fun meeting Ant and Dec, but I'm never quite sure which one's supposed to be the funny one.
I made all my friends and teachers laugh. That's why I like doing comedy, because when they laugh, it makes me happy. My dad and my brother inspired me to do comedy, and they helped me write some of my jokes.
I'm really happy that I'm in the semi-finals, but I want to get to the final a lot.
I've practiced for a really long time for tonight's performance. I've got more jokes about the judges, so they have to watch out. Stay savage.
Who here is enjoying themselves? Well, some people said that my audition was a bit rude for a kid. So in the end, the producers gave me this. Here goes. What do you call a duck with a broken leg? Lame! Who wrote this rubbish? David Williams? Last time, I'm trying to come up with some nice things to say about you.
And you can't think of any.
So please help me get through to the final, because I'm going to need a lot more time.
Ned, I would never press my button.
Save you the trouble.
I would never press my button.
At my audition, I only managed to get one joke out before I heard that sound that we all dread.
My laugh.
But after a while, you get used to Alicia's laugh. I love being on BGT. All these losers desperate to be famous. Or as they're otherwise known, the judges. Don't be rude to the elderly. Really? It's my birthday next week, and my auntie gave me a present. She said don't open it until your actual birthday, because it's bad luck. I thought, that's a nasty thing to get a kid for their birthday. And then there's my nan. She still inherited my granddad's big brown eyes. That made me cry. Because what I really wanted was his money. It's tough being up here, bright light, shining my eyes, nothing from Simon's teeth. But he does look good for his age. He's intelligent, talented, generous, and humble. He told me himself. I took my dog to the vet because he was poorly, and the vet said if you don't treat him immediately, he could die. So I took him to Disneyland. But he still died. But I soon cheered up because I got to meet my favourite double act. They really make me laugh. Eventually, I had to say, Holly, Philip. I've got to go. Meant to be meeting Ant and Dec in an hour. Congratulations, by the way, on becoming OBEs. I don't even know what that means. My guess is old, boring entertainers. Good news, isn't it, David? Because there's a strong chance that you'll be next. Now, you're probably wondering why my parents let me get away with being so cheeky. But what you should be wondering is how I started off this performance in a grey jacket and ended it wearing a camouflage t-shirt.
Simon, over to you.
Ned, you know what? I've just got a feeling in about 10 years' time you might be sitting in this chair instead of me. You are so funny, so cheeky. I mean, the dog joke with Amanda, honestly, is one of the funniest things we ever had on this show. And the fact that Amanda didn't find it funny made it even funnier for me. You know what's so funny about you as well is that, look, it's so... How old are you?
Well, I've been 9 for 4 days.
Oh, I see that. No, look, you're 9 years old, you come on this live show, no nerves, you know, gave us a hard time, I love it. Brilliant, good for you.
Wow, that was an incredibly confident performance from anyone, let alone someone who's just 4 days into their 9th birthday. You're like a very cute little kitten that you might stroke, and as soon as you do, they bite you. That's what I look upon you as. But brilliant jokes, brilliantly delivered. Well done, Ned.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I love how cheeky you are. That was so confident. It was written so well, and I think you are a star of the future. That was really, really good.
And Amanda.
Yes.
You both.
Nedless.
Yeah, you both.
What can I say? I would never have pressed my buzzer. You can know that for sure, because you were brilliant this evening. I thought, although it was savage, it was much cleverer than your previous audition. The jokes were better. And even though they were aimed at us all, they were wittier. I thought they were much better. They were less hurtful.
Ned, did you watch telly and go, oh, yeah, can't wait to roast them. Can't wait to have a go at them.
Yeah, yeah.
You do?
It was just like, watching BGT, roast her, maybe him, her.
Savage.
Well done, pal,
and
well
if you
done.
Want to see Ned being savage in the final and stay in the running for the Royal Variety, the number to call is 09020 442404 from the landline. From your mobile at 644 2404 or vote via the app. But remember, voting doesn't start until we've seen all 8 acts. One more time, Ned Woodman!
Savage!
Is the 9-year-old stand-up who's taken the mickey out of the judges twice. I'll tell you what, once this show finishes, I would not like to be in his shoes.
They fit you, though.
What?
His shoes, they fit you. He's size 3 as well.
Don't be ridiculous. I'm 3 and a half.
Oh, yeah, he's 3 and a half.
It's Ned Woodman.
I'm Ned, I'm 9, and I'm a comedian. I live in Maidstone with my family. I have one brother and 2 sisters.
I like making my brother and sister laugh. As well as telling jokes, I like climbing trees, reading, and doing cricket and gymnastics. To be in the final of Britain's Got Talent is really amazing. If I won Britain's Got Talent, I'd probably buy my family a nice holiday and buy myself a house. Performing at the semi-final was incredible.
It's tough being up here. Bright lights shining my eyes. Nothing from Simon's teeth.
The runner-up of tonight's public vote.
I was really, really scared when I was standing there waiting.
Ned Woodman!
I couldn't believe it when Anton Deck said that I was through to the final.
Well done, mate.
It was the happiest I've been so far when I got through. My ultimate dream is to win Britain's Got Talent because a comedian has never won and I'd love to be the first. Tonight, I'm not just going to pick on the judges. Celebrities, you better watch out.
Savage. Yeah. Just one quick question. Who here absolutely hates doing the Mexican wave? I want a show of hands, starting over here and moving all the way across. See, wasn't that bad? Magicians are doing so well on the show this year, so I've decided to do some magic of my own. Oh, wait, David? Here I have an envelope. Okay. Could you just please look after this? Don't let anybody see it and protect it.
Of course.
With all your heart.
Thank you.
So, for my first trick, I'm going to make the judges' smiles disappear. Oh, wait, already did that by getting through to the final. calm down. After my last performance, I decided to give you guys a break.
Hooray!
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's long enough. I just want to thank Ant and Dec for all the money that they spent voting for me to get through. The length some people go to just to make themselves look taller. How scary were those clowns last night? I haven't seen wacky costumes and terrifying makeup like that since Sharon Osbourne was a judge. You gotta love shows like Britain's Got Talent and X Factor. Where else you get to see that tedious singing robot? Gary Barlow. I was at the school disco and sat by the dance floor was a girl that I really liked. So I plucked up the courage to ask her if she wanted to dance. And she did, which was lucky for me, because otherwise I wouldn't have a place to sit. One Direction have gone their separate ways. That's ironic. Now, for those of you who don't know what ironic means, Simon, it's like these guys judging a talent competition. I'd like to remind you to vote Ned. I'd love to have a chance to perform in front of royalty. But if I did, I know it wouldn't be Prince Philip. That dude has got some savage material. But he's retired from his royal duties. So who's going to travel the world offending people now? Hello? Oh, and David, yes. Do me a solid and post that to Buckingham Palace. It's just a letter of apology for what I might say if I win.
Start with you.
I love the fact that we just keep laughing every time he destroys us night after night. Like, yeah, you made us look really horrible again. Thank you. Are you sure I'm not your dad?
100%.
Oh, good. Just thought I'd check. Look, you know what? You're on the verge of being annoying and really, really likeable, which I think, like, I've made a career out of that, so it's fine.
Hang on, what about the likeable bit?
Well, I'm still likeable at times. No, but you know what? I have to hand it to you. You have stuck to what you've done from day one. You've taken the pee out of us. It has worked. You are funny. God help the royal family if you win.
Yeah. Do you know how hard it is for a comedian?
Well, you know, suddenly, actually, I'm really excited about the idea of you performing at the Royal Variety Performance and blowing any chance you might have of ever getting an OBE. you know what? It takes real guts to get up there for anybody, right? You're 9 years old and you're doing the hardest thing to do on this show, which is comedy. And I think you did fantastically well tonight, so well done.
For you. You must have been so nervous tonight, but we would have never known. You are trouble, and I love it. Well done, Ned.
Yes, I'm just relieved, Ned, because I honestly thought that Sharon Osbourne gag was for me. So sorry about
never.
That, Sharon, but I'm just happy it wasn't for me.
Maybe, but
you did. Do you know what? You did really well. There was some really good material in there. And as Alicia said, comedy is a lonely platform, and you stood there on your own, and that? You did really. Well, I kind of said it, but Alicia said that he was scared. It is a lonely place to be when you're on the stage on your own, and you did an excellent job, so well done.
Thank you, Anna. Well done, Ned. You've done it, you've performed in the final. And if you want to give Ned a royal appointment, the number called from a landline is 09020442404. From your mobile, call 644-2404 or vote for free via the app, but not until we've seen every act tonight. One more time, Ned Woodman!
Next up are a mind-reading double act.
Hey, now, did you know I can...